My name is Roland Baron, and as every year, I am in charge of presenting a summary or the highlights of the basic science and translational science papers presented at the ASBMR meeting. And this year, certainly one of the most striking accumulation of new data has been on the phenomenon of cellular senescence, which is, if you want, the mechanism by which individual cells age, but of course it's different from aging at the individual level. There was, however, a number of papers also on aging, and of course cellular senescence is directly related to aging as well. And what these papers, and as I said, there are several, highlighted is the fact that cellular senescence contributes to the involution of the skeleton during aging, and that if you target this process by the use of a new family of drugs called senolytics, you can actually, at least so far in animal studies, prevent the loss with aging, and even correct the loss that has occurred in animals with aging. So this group of papers were really very striking and open a new field of investigation and potentially real translational investigations. I was also struck by the findings that 1,25-dihydroxyvitamin D3 prevents the emergence of spontaneous tumors in mice as well, and in part that this prevention was accomplished by preventing cellular senescence, adding to this aging group of papers. And last on this topic is an interesting paper also showing that osteocalcin from bone can have a significant effect on the cognitive function in aged mice. All of this focusing again on this aging phenomenon. The second set of very striking findings this year are related to the role of sex hormone, estrogens and androgens, but this time not in bone, where we know that they have a lot of functions, of course, or in other organs, but this time in the brain. And there are two papers, one on estrogen and one on androgen, showing that actually these receptors in the central nervous system play a critical role in the regulation of bone metabolism and homeostasis. Now this is kind of reverse thinking, and also the fact that they have opposite effects, AR, androgen receptor and estrogen receptor, and that these effects are opposite to what estrogen in particular is known to do when acting directly in bone. These were very striking results that will change the way we are thinking about all of that. Now there was a set of abstracts on the interactions between bone and fat, bone and muscle. In the bone and muscle, the translational aspect is that by targeting a muscle mass with various agents, you can actually improve also bone mass and bone quality in mice models of osteogenesis imperfecta. Then there was very interesting progress in the understanding of notch signaling, wind signaling, which we see almost every year in the last few years. Very significant progress on the identification of skeletal stem cells in the growth plate, but also this year, very strikingly, a cluster of abstracts on identifying stem cells in the periosteum, which, as we know, is very important in fracture healing, but also in the regulation of the geometry of the long bones in particular. And finally, I want to emphasize some significant progress also still in animal models, of course, on the understanding of osteosarcoma and on new targets that could be used to interfere with the tumor progression. And as you know, there is no treatment as of today, so these are particularly important novel findings that could potentially be translated into clinical treatments. So with all this being said, I of course encourage you very strongly to listen to our presentation, which goes in, of course, much more detail and also mentions some abstracts I did not have time to do here. Thank you very much.